Hi guys, thanks for tuning in to Zen Romance Tarot. We're going to take a look at Leo. Hey Leo, hope everything's going okay out there. I did meditate over these cards. We're going to take a look and see what's going on with you. Hey, before we do that, ask a question, guys. Make a wish, whatever. Yeah, question, wish, think something. All right, let's see what comes out. Let me just actually, while I'm here on camera, give it a nice little. All right, guys. Make a wish. I'm gonna pull two. You're ready. Look at that. You're ready. I'm gonna put that over there. You can't see it on camera, but it is there. Okay, one more. One more, guys. Let's see if you have anything else. It looks like you're ready for something. You're ready for big, happy changes. Oh, man. All right. Awesome. Okay, guys. So, let's take a look and see what's going on with your energy, Leo. Leo, I kind of feel like you might be ignoring your intuition when it comes to some situation. It could be a relationship. That's what it looks like. You might be ignoring your intuition. You were able to see that a little bit. I feel like you're not paying attention to something that you know. Okay. And I feel like there is no light. May as well hang out with me for a minute. Is this even on? You might hear computer music. Yeah, okay. Sorry about that, guys. Okay. So, yeah, I feel like you guys might be ignoring your intuition. This is the High Priestess reversed. Okay, so you could be disconnected from your intuition. You might be relying too heavily on outside sources. Anybody external that you might go to, you're relying too heavily on them for guidance or something. It's a situation in some cases where you may be saying a little bit too much, Leo. So what you might want to do is just kind of go and seek answers within. All right? You're seeking answers to something that you believe might be a secret, or there's something hidden, or there's something you don't know. And for some reason, you know what? I think I'm going to ask whoever. I'm not going to worry about asking, you know, whoever, like a higher power. I'm not going to worry about doing that. I'm just going to ask. No, you're being advised to go within and see whatever's going on here. All right. So the next energy I have for you guys, Leo, this is an Ace of Cups. And again, it's reversed. Now, you could be feeling empty or depleted in some situation or relationship. I feel like there could have been some disappointment in a relationship. Whenever we have the Ace of Cups, it talks about something new. All right, something new, like a new beginning. It could be a new relationship, a marriage, or something like that. But I feel like because this is reversed, it's something that you were disappointed in. So there was some situation, I believe, with Affairs of the Heart. And if I put this together, I feel like there were some secrets that may have been hidden, or maybe you had some suspicions of something, right? And I kind of feel like with you guys, you were disappointed because you may have found out something, or had a feeling about something, or had confirmation on something. That something wasn't right in the matter, all right? And so just the relationship didn't go the way you wanted it to. So I kind of feel like this whole thing is about a relationship. Let's look at the Queen of Swords here. So this card talks about decisiveness, right? And it's really funny because when we have decisiveness with the Queen of Swords, we just pulled You're Ready and Big Happy Changes. I'll pull those again in a second. But we pulled the Queen of Swords here. Now this is somebody who is going to take a logical approach. In some situation, it could be you dealing with, let's put it this way, Leo. This could be the person that you're actually dating, all right? This person is a very intellectual person, very strong person, very smart person. This person could be a single parent, is what I'm showing. This person, it was something else about this person. This person could be a single parent. Oh, yeah, that part, that's probably why I suppressed that. This person could have recently lost their partner. And I believe with this card is something that had to be said. You know, that's really not one of those things you can avoid. So you guys might be dealing with somebody who recently lost their partner. Or you could be dealing with somebody who's a single parent. Also, I feel like this person might actually be good because they're very sweet, they're intellectual, but they say what it is they have to say. And I kind of feel like here, I don't know if you believe that about them, or maybe you're suspicious about something. I don't know why we have Queen of Swords energy. Let me, do I have any cards? I'm sure I do. Let's see if we can pull some cards to find out. Help me understand why we have Queen of Swords. Why do we have Queen of Swords? Why do we have Queen of Swords? Okay, this could be your energy, where you're just like, I'm all set. I'm going to be strong. I'm going to be this. I'm going to be that. That could just be your energy. But these cards do say if you're in a relationship, it is probably with somebody who lost a partner recently or is a single parent. Okay, tell me more about Queen of Swords for Leo, please. Queen of Swords for Leo. Okay. You guys found out there were going to be some delays in something, and I think there was a little bit of disappointment with that. I do see that here. Maybe there's some kind of something having to do with groups and being back together. All right, and just being connected again with somebody. There's going to be delays here, but somebody wants to grow something. I feel like there's a relationship where you want to create like abundance and maybe expand. Maybe you guys are looking to have a child, because if you see Ace of Cups, it also talks about a new baby or a relationship. I feel like there's some planning here, but I feel like because somebody, I don't know if you went within, Leo. You may have gone within and realized some things, and now you're just like delays in love. I feel like there's going to be delays here. I feel like somebody disappointed you because there's a delay. Hold on. Oh, jeez. All right, we have the Three of Swords reversed. There's threes here. All right. I feel like there was... All right, somebody interrupted the relationship. Now, if I really look at this, I could say there was... this could have been air sign that ruined your... Or stepped in. Or Camila showed up in a relationship. It could be that. So, yeah. That was third party. That's air energy. Okay. So, we see why you're disappointed. So, is there anything else we need to know about Ace of Cups? What was delayed? What was delayed? What was supposed to... Oh, my goodness. Ace of Swords. Frustrations. Okay. Okay. I feel like, Leo, you were with somebody. Good jeez. This is more air energy, guys. This is Libra, Aquarius, Gemini. So, some of you guys could have been dealing with Libra, Aquarius, Gemini. We have the High Priestess here. I do see Pisces and I see water, but I see a ton of air here. I also see, yep. Yeah, okay. I think that's fire. I gotta look that one up. But yeah, it looks like this is more air energy. I feel like it's air. Okay. Something that, yeah, is basically disappointment in a relationship. Hollow victories, meaning I don't necessarily feel like I have you. I feel like there's something that you're hiding. Hold on. Okay, that makes sense. High Priestess, okay, is reversed. I think what looks like may have happened is if you haven't realized that you need to depend on yourself and go within versus seeking other people and telling them, I guess, your business or having to look around or whatever this is, right? You might be going into hermit mode. I think this has to do with a relationship, right? Loneliness, unattached. I feel like there's going to be some kind of delays with somebody who you were supposed to connect with. And I feel like this person may have been involved with somebody else. We do have Virgo. I see that. So I don't know what that means to you guys. This one I got to look up. But it says you're ready. Big happy changes. Now, I don't know. That could just be whatever your question is, or if you can... You can put it into this reading, but it looks like you're gaining clarity with the Queen of Swords. And I think the clarity shows that there might have been somebody else, because then we have the Three of Swords. Let me just make sure that's there. All right. So that's kind of what I see for you guys. I feel like you guys are acknowledging that there was some third party interruption, or maybe you didn't fully have this person. And I think you had to go within, because you were ignoring your intuition, but when you went within, you kind of saw the whole picture for what it is. All right, now let's see. What advice? I can't even call this advice. This is not advice. Angel answers. Angel answers. Let's see. What do we have for Leo in love? Leo in love, give me some good news about the future. Just give me Leo's energy and love. Leo's energy and love. After they realized about this finances and career. Financial issues are a factor in your love life right now. Okay. So what I'm getting is Leo's not necessarily concerned about love at the moment. Leo's more concerned about getting their bread because they have to. This is about finances and career. This is something I have to do for myself. So that, honestly, you guys have to understand that whenever things are done, it's usually in preparation or it's usually the result of something that you've gone through. So I feel like financially you guys are trying to get yourselves in order. And I don't know that love is number one on your mind right now. You might be busy with other stuff. Pay attention to red flags. The signs are cautioning you. Mm-hmm. I also feel like that you going forward, you guys are going to see, you know, start paying attention to signs because I see where, and let's look at this. I see where you're ignoring the signs. You see High Priestess over here? You're ignoring everything. Okay. Pisces. Oh, wedding. Oh, okay. So some of you guys might be engaged to somebody or something like that. Pay attention to the red flags, whatever that's supposed to be about. Especially if you know that this person had you in a third party. And maybe this person decided, hey, I'm the one for you now. And you're like, yeah, okay. But in the back of your mind, why? Because look at how you're looking at him. He looks scared. And you look like, I wish you would. I don't know. I'm just being funny. But guys, I don't know. I think that there's a decision that Leo is. There was somebody. I feel like this is a person that you wanted to be with, but they weren't fully yours. You never really had their heart 100% for whatever reasons. It could be any interruption. You know, any outside factors. It could be, I don't know, if this person had kids, the kids don't like you or whatever the situation is, right? Or whatever. It could be any, the mother don't like you. It could be all these outsides. It's just funny. But you understand what I'm saying? But at the end of the day, you get to look around and see somebody had you in a third party. This was the funniest reading, but it's not funny. It's so weird. It's like, what is this? Anyway, Leo, hey, somebody that you thought you were going to have, like, I want to say, like, this long-term and, I don't know, some, all right, guys, that's all I got. I love you. Bye.